Born in 1905, General Yang Jingyu, a renowned Chinese military commander, died in his battle against Japanese invaders in 1940. He has since been remembered by the Chinese people as a national hero. On September 18, 1931, the Imperial Japanese Army began a planned bombardment of Chinese barracks near Shenyang in northeast China under a false pretext. That marked the beginning of the bloody invasion of the northeast and then the rest of China by imperialist Japan, which lasted 14 years. Yang had been dispatched to northeast China to fight Japanese invaders in 1932 under the pseudonym Zhang Guanyi.
九一八事变之后呢，张冠仪亲眼目睹了祖国的山河破碎，他无法忍受日本侵略者的铁蹄践踏祖国的山河，于是呢，他就将全部的精力投入到了东北的抗战中。Later,
under his real name once more, Yang Jingyu served as the commander and political commissar of the anti-Japanese amalgamated army of northeast China. With flexible guerrilla tactics, Yang repeatedly defeated the Japanese invaders with a significantly smaller force than theirs. Yang led more than 40 engagements in Jilin province, despite a critical lack of supplies.
1939年底到1940年初, 日伪军调动大批兵力讨伐杨靖宇所率领的第一路军, 尽管杨靖宇实行了化整为零等等游击战术，也摆脱不了敌人的跟踪追击。
In February 1940, Yang was killed in battle after a fierce fight. The Japanese dissected his body, finding only undigested grass roots, cotton batting, and tree bark left in his stomach, and not a single grain of rice. He had eaten no real food for 5 consecutive days before dying.
中国人民抗日战争胜利是以爱国主义为核心的 民族精神的伟大胜利，是中国共产党发挥中流砥柱作用的伟大胜利，是全民族众志成城、奋勇抗战的伟大胜利，是中国人民同反法西斯同盟国以及各国人民并肩战斗的伟大胜利。我们重温习近平总书记讲述的杨俊的故事，
能够深切地感受到，正是无数共产党人的前赴后继，才成就了百年大党的辉煌历史。我们要赓续共产党人精神血脉，把革命先烈为之奋斗、为之牺牲的伟大事业不断推向前进。